For First at 8, the future of Australia will be decided in the next 24 hours as Aussies prepare to head to the polls. Today, a new poll shows Labor's primary vote has fallen to 36, while the Coalition has jumped 3 points to 35. After preferences, Labor is leading 53 to 47. We spoke to Prime Minister Scott Morrison a short time ago.
And it's going to come down to who can best manage money. And what we've seen over the course of this campaign is Mr Albanese just isn't across it.
Live to our reporters and first to federal politics reporter Fiona Whelan in Perth, who's with the Prime Minister. Fee, it's going to be neck and neck.
Ali, the Prime Minister says that polls don't decide elections, but I can tell you both sides certainly watch them very closely at this stage of the game. And this is actually the second one this week that shows that gap has narrowed. The Prime Minister has started his day here in Perth with a bit of a spring in his step after yesterday's jobs figures, which show that unemployment has hit its lowest point in 48 years. So the Prime Minister is using those figures to try to drive home his argument that the Coalition should be in charge of the economy.
It was only 2 years ago we were facing unemployment rates of 15%. Getting it down to 3.9%, ensuring 92,500 extra full-time jobs just in the last month alone. That's what gives people confidence.
Anthony Albanese is expected to visit three states today as he tries to convince voters that it's time for change. Ali?
Thanks, Jess. Let's bring in Jessica Millwood now in the battleground seat of Lilly in Brisbane. Jess, you've got some breaking news for COVID-positive voters.
I do, Ali, and it is good news. The Australian Electoral Commission has told Ben Fordham on 2GB just a few moments ago that a brief has been approved recommending the government change the regulation to now allow COVID-positive people from last Friday onwards to use the phone voting system. So people in isolation will be able to vote tomorrow. It was looking like some people wouldn't be able to, but you do need to apply for that phone vote and show proof that you have a positive PCR or rapid antigen test. The two leaders are hoping to win over voters at last minute today, but plenty of people have already made their decision. This pre-polling location here in the seat of Lilly, very busy, and it only opened a few moments ago. Ali.
And that is a big development this morning. Thanks, Jess.
Yeah, huge. Devastated families have hit out in response to Victoria's overhaul of the state's emergency system. Christina Hearn is across the story from Melbourne. Chris, what did that report find?
Charles, it was a damning report and found that our emergency call-taking service was acting more like a call centre rather than an emergency management service. It's made 20 recommendations to try and finally fix the system, but according to family members we've spoken to who lost loved ones waiting for an ambulance, it's too little too late.
Well, the revamp is unimpressive, to say the least. What they've done is they're changing a name. It's like changing the name of the Titanic after it's already sunk.
The system will also be rebranded and known as 000 Victoria. Charles?
Chris, thank you. Grieving families of Victorians forced to wait for an ambulance say a promised overhaul of the state's failing 000 system is too little too late. For more, we're joined by David Edwards in Swan Hill in Victoria, whose father sadly passed away in January after waiting over 40 minutes for help. David, I'm sorry we're meeting under these circumstances. You know how much pain can be caused by this system. You've seen the revamp. What's your response?
Well, the revamp is unimpressive, to say the least. What they've done is they're changing a name. It's like changing the name of the Titanic after it's already sunk. It's ridiculous. And the person in charge, Jacqueline Symes, is still in charge. She's in charge, was in charge of the old system. Now she'll be in charge of the new system. So the person at the top, the person that's caused all of this, is still in charge of the system. Why hasn't she been sacked? Why hasn't she resigned? She is the one that's the fault. She has run the place down. Some budget cuts and people don't want to work there. It's all her department, all her fault. Get rid of her.
It's interesting you mentioned the budget cuts. The report into some of this found there were three key issues, one of them being a lack of staff, one of them being resources and flexibility. What do you think is to blame?
She's to blame. Nobody wants to work for her. The department is stuffed.
And beyond just losing her, what else do you see needs to change into the future?
Oh, get it right. Get the system working properly. Look, it's not rocket science. Somebody rings up, answers the phone, get an ambulance. 1, 2, 3, done.
There were 20 recommendations here. Are any of these good suggestions in your eyes?
Well, when it comes down to it, it's all just words and gobbledygook on a piece of paper. Yeah. They're not changing anything. The departments have changed. It'll probably just change some more bureaucrats from one place to another and nothing will change. So what, they've changed the board, big deal.
Now, what does it mean to you then to see this result and see after this review and looking into it, after all that you've lost, to see that this is the response?
I'm a bit disappointed, to be honest, because at the end of it, we'll be paying for all of this.
David, appreciate your time this morning. I know it's a tough time and has been a tough year, and we hope there are better answers ahead for you.
It's a disgrace. She'll be sacked.
Thank you, mate.
His anger there is clear, isn't it? Well, now to a today weather alert. And look, I'm sorry to spoil your Friday. Cold temperatures in the southeast are set to continue into the weekend as heavy rain returns to an already drenched Queensland. Let's bring in Jenny Sturrock from the Bureau of Meteorology. Jenny, just how cold is it going to get?
Look, over southeastern parts, we're seeing temperatures around 4 degrees below average, so dropping well close to the zero mark, into the -3 for the alpine areas. And just a nice wintry blast to remind us that winter is on its way.
Yay, is all I can say to that one. But look, I mean, New South Wales and Queensland, just talk me through the rainfall, the heavy rainfall that's expected, and how long do you think that's all going to last?
Yeah, so we're obviously seeing some rainfall off a deepening trough starting today, continuing Saturday. Now, for Queensland, we will start to see an easing trend Sunday, but the easing trend for New South Wales will probably come more Monday. We're going to see falls of around that 20 to 30 millimetres each day, some isolated heavier falls. Now, while those totals might not sound too scary, as you mentioned, it's falling on very sodden ground. So with all the heavy rainfall we've experienced and flooding, we're just keeping a very close eye on things.
Just keeping that close eye on central Queensland, which areas there are of most concern with all this, with the flood warnings?
Look, at this stage, we think the heavier falls will be along coastal fringes and just the adjacent areas there, so through central and down to southeastern parts of Queensland. So we're sort of keeping our eye on that Caboolture through to Rockhampton region for the flooding responses there.
Gee whiz, it's a whole lot of rain, isn't it? Just to end too, I know there's now a new way to get weather alerts direct to our phones. Please tell.
Yeah, so we've upgraded our app, and so now you get what we call push notifications. So when you've set your location, the warnings that are going to be relevant to you will come straight through as an alert ping to notify you that that's come through. So hopefully that's going to help just wade through all the data that everyone's bombarded with every day to know that this one you need to take notice of and take action around.
All right, so we know we need to get our brolly out. We know we need to rug up for the next couple of days ahead. All right, thank you, Jenny.